Growing up in Australia, you got a lot of hot summers and got a lot of sunny days to ride, but then also the tracks are super dusty. Yeah, I guess we're a little bit disconnected, but you know, when you're younger and you're growing up, you don't really worry about it too much. And then, you know, when I start to travel overseas and that's my job, it makes life a bit harder, but I've traveled all over the world and I wouldn't want to live anywhere else than Australia. I ride bikes just for the fun. It clears your mind and it's just the most fun thing that I've ever done in my whole entire life. Winning 2 world championships in a row just meant the world to me. I guess that's still kind of a dream in my head. Winning a World Cup race would almost mean more to me than winning the Junior World Championship. I'm right up there now. I know that's where I should be, and you know, technically I should be winning World Cups, and it's going to be hard, but it's definitely doable. Training's been good coming into 2014. It's the work that you put in before the race and who can break down the body the most and train the hardest. What motivates me would be getting beat. I don't like losing. It lights up a fire inside of you and makes you want to train harder. That's the only way you're going to win, if you're training harder than the opposition. After Peter Marisburg, we flew back with Mitch Ropelato, and he's just been staying here till Cairns, and it's been good. Mitch has just pretty much stamped that this is his ground now. He just comes in, does all the jumps, and throws a dip 3 that's on the biggest jump here.
Dude, this is amazing. He's got a sick crew to ride with, and like, funnest set of dirt jumps I've ever rode. They're freaking a blast.
Whenever the day is that the downhilling isn't fun for me, I'll probably hang those boots up. It's a fun sport, it doesn't have to be serious.
We got some koalas. We got, I think, a little baby one down low, and then mum or dad up top. The best leaves are always up top, so the big dogs go up there.
Yeah, at home, it's pretty fun just going flat out at local trail. You know every pebble. You can kind of ride it over the limit of what you think you can, and I feel like that's where you want to do your most training. Once you get to the limit, then you can back it down a little. Goals for a Cairns home race in Australia is definitely going to be win, you know. It would mean the most to me to win in front of the hometown. I've got nothing to lose, I guess. I'm fully healthy. Now it's time to push over the limit and go for those race wins.
Yeah, round 2 here in Australia. I think Troy feels good. The energy of Australia and being in his home country, there's always a boost on that. You always feel that little extra support. So I think he's excited. You know, those guys work together, and it's refreshing to see Aaron and Troy both talking over lines and working together. I like the relationship between those guys. Two heads are better than one, and sometimes you miss things that your teammate might catch.
Went from just normal conditions, I guess, first run, and then it just bucketed down, and now it's the muddiest, slipperiest track I've probably ever ridden. It would be better if it rains the whole time to a race run, but probably be pretty claggy, I think. This rain and Cairns is not quite in my comfort zone of where I ride at home, but it's so much fun, and you know, we don't have to go fast today, we just need to find our lines and stay on track, really.
I think Troy's doing great. It's the same for everybody. It's a mess up there, and you're not going to get comfortable, and that's what mud races are, you know? The sooner you get your mindset into being uncomfortable and being okay with it, that's when you can let go and just hang on to it. That's what you do on these things. Just let it go, man, and hang on and try to get as many points as you can.
It is race day here in Cairns. Should be fun, it's going to be a good day. Keen to just go up there and race and kind of get it over and done with. Looked back at my run yesterday and the time I did, and there's a lot of places where I was kind of riding tentative and made some stupid mistakes. So today's going to be a lot better, and we'll just give it all I got race run.
Gonna have a lot of support, a lot of people cheering him down all the way, so hopefully he can feed off that and it can drive him to the line. The work's been done, his training's been done, now it's just a matter of him to get in the house and execute.
Looking good, looking clean, doesn't get loud, he needs your help to come into the finish.
down in for ninth, but I didn't come here to get ninth. I came here to get on the podium and win it. So I'm happy to get down. This mud was brutal. I was, you know, a little bit tentative and kind of lost heaps of time up the top. But apart from that, I'm happy. You know, I'm still in one piece and we're looking good for the season. We've just got to keep moving forward and just keep, you know, stepping up the game each week. And yeah, that's good for Aaron. I'm stoked for him to be leading still. And it's, you know, as much as you go race to race, you always got in the back of your head that you want to stay on top of the points. And, you know, you got to take the good from the bad. And I think Fort William and Lear gang will be on the podium again. And one of these days, I'll pull it off and be standing on that top step.